I'm Dan, and welcome again to Dan Jumba. This time, I'd like to share with you a simple creative writing classroom tip. It's an activity that I've done with adults and children, and it's something you can do very easily at any time. So to start this activity, all you need is pen and paper. Have your participants or your group all ready, and then ask them to just list out things that you can think about based on this statement. So the statement will be, tell them to describe the room, okay, or describe this room. So it depends on which room you're in. It doesn't matter if the room is plain or drab, or if it's outdoor, it's all right. So you can try it yourself as well. So think about this. How would you describe the room that you're currently in right now? I've done this many, many times, and the most common answers, regardless of where I'm in or what the room is like, would be things like, I see a blue wall, or I see something hanging on a wall, or there is a door, there are three windows. So very often the answers are all visual, meaning that things you can see. So the whole point here is to ask them, great, you know, you have identified all the things that you can see. How about things you can hear? How about things you can smell? How about things that you can touch and maybe even taste? And that's where people start to really think about things. And as you look around the room, you might see that, oh, I can hear the whirring of a fan. I could hear a radio being played. I could smell food being cooked from the kitchen nearby. I could perhaps even taste a slight salty tang from the sea breeze. So this whole activity brings up a whole new sensorial world that we often neglect. So it's a good thing to try, okay? And kids love it because then they start to really express themselves in all kinds of ways. And adults just start to think about why we are so dominantly visual. Now, if you have more time, you can follow this up with another activity. And this activity is something that I really like to do because it really engages the participants, your kids. So give them, first of all, candy. Here I have a packet of gummy candy. It could be really anything. It could also be food items like a slice of pizza. And ask them to write about it, and not just about the taste, but from the very beginning. For example, I could write that this is in the blue plastic packet. It has the words yuppie on it. It crinkles when I do this. I can't really smell anything. So the whole challenge is to kind of describe what you have in your hand and using all of your five senses. So this is a really fun way to build up on that sensory writing experience. So hopefully with these two activities, you can introduce creative writing to your kids or as a way to spice up a meeting or a workshop. So have fun. Do come back and I'll share a few more things I've been doing in my classroom. And please do subscribe. Thank you for watching. I'll see you again.